right, guys. Well, Cora tried out the little Savage Bait pulse tail crappie. She didn't really like the results of it, but anyway, she's gonna throw this little tiny torpedo. It's in a clear. We got high clear sky, so I think she made a good choice on that. So you guys stay tuned to Cora Gale on Greenfish Nation. Cora, let her eat.
Oh.
This is a twitch, twitch, pause, twitch, twitch, pause. She's good at these kind of baits.
Oh my God.
Looky there. The top water done paid off on the first cast.
Yeah. Again.
Yep. He got off, didn't he? Here. Dad'll get him and put him back in the water.
Yeah, at least he didn't get off in water.
Yep. All right. That lure there's a little lighter than that other one, ain't it?
Yeah. But it sure does catch good fish already.
Yep, caught one on the first cast. Now, are you doing something different than you did on the first cast?
No.
Remember, you were twitch, twitch, pause, twitch, twitch,
yeah.
Pause. All right, give her a whirl out across there.
First, I was trying to get that turtle away.
Yeah. Set the hook.
Oh.
Remember, you got to leave it down about 12 inches from the end of your rod, remember?
Mm-hmm.
She's a little out of practice. She ain't been fishing with Dad and, oh, I don't know, it's been a couple months, hadn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Last time we went, she caught her first lake fish on a crankbait at Lake Hallbrook. Hey, and when you cast, you're casting it all the way to the ground like this.
Okay.
Remember, hold it at a 45 degree angle like this right here. And cast it at a 45 degrees. Not straight up, not straight sideways, but halfway in between, okay?
Okay.
You're doing a great job, Corgale. There you go. That was a nice cast. Just work it back and be ready to set the hook. It's going to be that same sweeping hook set, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Anytime your rod's low like that, you're going to make that sweeping hook set.
Mm-hmm.
With a top water or some type of moving bait, okay?
Okay.
Now, if you was fishing a worm, you'd have time to go down there and reel up your slack.
Oh, that was a good one.
That was a great cast. Let's walk right down here and cast up by these trees right down here.
Yeah.
Guys, we're going to change spots. We got some fish that are just acting plumb silly down here. All right, fire away.
Oh.
You know why that happened?
Because it wasn't fully.
Because it was wasn't 12 inches from the end of your rod. Look what happened. Remember, you reeled it up all the way, okay?
Yep.
And then it hooked on the other line. So it just takes practice. You'll get it, okay? So reel it up, right about there. Now, step up a little bit where you're further away from the edge of the bank. There you go, 45 degrees. Hold it, 45 degrees. Up like this. There you go, right there. Perfect.
Oh yeah,
perfect,
that makes
cast.
A big...
Looky there. Set the hook.
Oh my God.
Nice one. Good job. See how that sucker just came up and just sucked it under the water?
Mm-hmm. Whew.
Man, look at you go. You're just catching fish left and right today, ain't you?
Oh.
All right. Just work it from right there. Maybe he'll come see you. All right, reel it on up and make you another cast over that way. Perfect. Work it a little harder, make a little more noise with it. Easy, he didn't get it, he missed it. Let it sit there, just, okay, go ahead and reel it up. So if they miss it like that, a lot of times if you'll let it sit there and just give it a little small twitch, time or two,
mm-hmm.
let it sit there, they'll come back and hit it again, okay?
Okay.
There you go. Perfect, looky there, you're learning. What a cast. Looked like Bill Dance throwed that lure out there. Set the hook.
Oh,
you
man.
Missed him. You gotta be quicker, sister. They're just not committing to it, are they? So they're short striking it, all right?
Mm-hmm.
So I think we need to change lure colors.
Yeah, I don't think they like the color.
Well, I think they like it. They just can't see it good enough. Hey, guys, we're going to go ahead and pause this for just a second. We're going to go up here and we're going to get another tiny torpedo and see if we can't get them to go ahead and commit. So you guys stay tuned. All right, guys, we got the same size torpedo. Got a little frog color. It's green and yellow, something a little darker. Of course, that you're going to give us a try. Cora also said she seen one of these shirts like this at Academy that was pink and her mama told her no, she couldn't get it. I'm telling you, mama, nobody tells baby girl no. You better get that girl a pink shirt next time. Y'all hang in there.
Oh, this one makes a bunch of noise.
What happened, Corgell? Bought it right at the bank?
Yeah.
Well, I'll be daggum.
This one makes a whole lot of noise because of the metal piece on the back, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Boy, I tell you, it does act up, don't it?
Mm-hmm.
You know why that is?
Why?
Because Dad bent the back blade just ever so slightly, so it causes a lot more commotion.
Oh.
That's one of those tricks of the trade. Look at there. Put it right in his neighborhood, guys.
That's weird. He's not making as much a sound. Oop.
What happened?
Lesson
time here. What happened?
I don't know. I think... Oh, it's okay now. I can get this one.
You think it might have happened because you reeled it all the way up to the rod tip?
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Okay, it's okay. That's how we learn. We make mistakes, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so... If you learn that one thing today...
Yeah.
And you've already caught fish, so... The fishing trip's already been worth it, right?
Yeah.
Just work it right there. Sometimes good Lord puts that lure where it needs to be. Maybe not where you want it to be. That's a nice cast.
Oh, that's a nice breeze.
Oh, man, did you see that?
That was so close to the bank.
I thought he was going to get in your pocket there for a second. I think I'd see if I couldn't coax him into biting again.
Mm-hmm.
He thought, man, that thing's about to run up on the bank. I better eat it.
Oh, come here.
There you go.
Oh.
That's a good little fish, but I don't think that's the one that almost got in your pocket a while ago. Do you swing him on up on the bank? There you go. That way I ain't got to get down there and get him out of the mud.
It's a pretty good sized fish.
That's about like what you've been catching, ain't it?
Yeah.
If I can get this thing out of this fish without getting it in him, we'll be in top shape. Old Cora girl, she's getting her done, guys. One dinker at a time.
Oh, yeah.
Twitch it real easy. Twitch it easy.
Oh my God.
All right, go on reel up and get on back out there. See him chasing shad out there?
Oh my gosh.
Don't reel up too far, but make a good cast. Get back out there in the middle of them and throw it and let it set and be ready, okay? You see how important it is to be ready as soon as it hits the water?
Yep.
Like a bomb went off on that thing, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. What the heck?
He hit it and knocked it up in the air.
Maybe it's just a smaller fish coming. Oh my God. Come in for bites, because all the big fish seem to be jumping up and getting the flat. Oh, whoa, I got it hooked somewhere weird.
I got it came right out. This is prime time, guys. Right at about 30, 45 minutes before dark, and they are biting.
All right, get it up and get going again. Longer you can keep that bait in the strike zone out there, the more fish you'll catch, okay?
Okay. Oh, man.
All right, let it set. Now give it a good twitch, and then let it set. There you go. Perfect. That's a good cast. Right on the edge of that moss out there in the pond.
All right, let it set. Let it set. That's a perfect cast. You couldn't have planned that no better. Now just twitch it easy, but be ready. Set the hook. Good job.
Oh!
Hold your rod up. Work him. Good job. Work him on up here. All right. Nice job, girl.
Oh, he's bigger.
All right. You got another cast or two in you?
Yep.
Another cast or two, another fish or two, huh?
Mm-hmm.
She's bound and determined to catch one off that grass line. Night before last was a full moon, and these brim will be spawning a couple more days. So they're wiring them out over on them brim beds. You about done?
Yeah.
Okay.